Good evening, teacher.
Hello, good evening. How are you?
I am fine, teacher. And you?
I'm very well. Thank you for asking.
Okay.
Ready for today's class?
Yes, ready for today's class. Empezar. Okay.
And?
Listo.
Ready.
Sí, listo, ¿verdad?
Ready, yeah.
Ready, okay, sí. Yes.
I'm ready. That's good. That's excellent. Hello, yes. Darwin.
Hello, teacher. Good evening.
Good evening. How do you feel today? How do you feel?
With all the power.
With all the powers. Oh my, I like that.
Yes.
All right. Very good. It's good to see you. Hello, Ada.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening. How are you doing?
Fine, teacher.
Oh, nice. Very good. Hello, Margarita.
Good evening.
Good evening. How are you doing?
Fine.
Oh, good. Did you connect yesterday?
No, teacher. Yesterday, I can't.
You're missing too many classes.
I could.
Ah, okay. You're missing too many classes.
Yes, teacher, I'm sorry. But but no sucederá. ¿Cómo es? No sucederá de nuevo.
It won't happen again. It won't happen again.
It will happen
again. Okay, hopefully. Hello, Miguel, sorry. How are you?
Fine, teacher, and you?
I'm very well. Thank you for asking. Hi, Michelle, Joanna, how are you?
Hi, teacher.
Hello, good evening.
Good evening. How are you? How are you, girls? Michelle and Joanna, Patricia?
I'm fine.
Oh, nice, very good. Ingrid is writing on the chat, I think, right? Okay. So for today, we are going to start unit number 3, okay? So we have unit number 3 for today. Ok, siempre la recomendación que no olviden. Hello, good evening. Bueno, siempre la recomendación de la cámara, ¿verdad? Que la cámara siempre debemos tenerla encendida. Ahorita Ingrid escribió que iba en el bus, pero para los demás sí siempre el requisito está, ¿verdad? De mantener la cámara encendida, por favor. Ok, so please have your cameras on. Unless you are working, okay? Al menos que estemos trabajando, okay? A veces cuando están en su celular y van al documento, a veces se les desaparece, ¿verdad? So this is the only situation. O tal vez a veces si van al baño también, ¿verdad? Lo apagan un momento y luego le encienden. Sorry?
Exactly.
Sorry, Azalia. I think Azalia was speaking, right?
Terminando de cenar, teacher.
Okay. Bon appetit. Buen apetito.
Thank you.
Okay, so let's start and let me pass the attendance. Ada Patricia.
Present, teacher.
Adriana. Ana Michelle. Ángela.
Present, teacher.
Darwin.
Present, teacher.
Flor. Gloria. Joana.
I'm here, teacher.
Okay, Lourdes.
I'm here, teacher.
Very good. I didn't see you yesterday, Lourdes. You didn't connect yesterday, right?
Yes, teacher, I have a problem in my reporters with my boss.
Oh, I see. All right. If it's because of work, no problem. Okay. Margarita?
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
I'm here.
Very good. Mayra? Miguel?
Present, teacher.
Nelson? Ofelia?
Here, teacher.
Okay. Osmin?
Present, teacher. Good evening.
Good evening. Rafael?
Present.
Very good. Rosa? Sandra?
Present, teacher.
Okay.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Yancy?
Present.
Zulma?
Present.
Azalia? Okay, Azalia?
Present.
Ingrid? And Susana? Susan? No, all right. Okay, very good. So let's just try to... it's okay, Ingrid. Okay, I read your message. Okay, so basically, yesterday we studied some vocabulary, right? And you were checking some definitions on Cambridge Dictionary and Oxford Dictionary, okay? About some vocabulary. What vocabulary did you check yesterday? Can you tell me the words you checked? Which words did you check in the dictionaries?
Thoroughly.
Dirt. Okay, dirt, thoroughly. What else? Dirt, thoroughly. What else?
Dispenser.
Dirt, thoroughly. What else?
Dirt, sink.
Sink. And
dictionary.
Can you repeat it, Miguel?
Designated.
Designated. Designated. All right. Designated. Yes, basically you studied these words, okay? What is dispenser? What is dispenser?
It's a container.
It's a container that holds things, right? Okay. Yeah. What kind of dispensers do we have? What kind of dispensers do we have? Okay. What kind of dispensers do you know?
So.
A soup dispenser. What else?
Candy's
dispenser.
Sorry, candy's dispenser. Sandra, you were saying one?
Lavamano, wash it.
Okay. Okay. Maybe you can say soap. Okay, soap dispenser. Okay, soap dispenser. Soap dispenser. Okay, so we have different dispensers, right? Good. Now, dirt. What is dirt? What is dirt? D-I-R-T, dirt. What is
sociedad.
Dirt? Sucio. Sociedad, okay, sociedad is a noun, all right? Sucio is dirty, it's different. So dirt is sociedad, all right?
Sociedad.
Dirt, dirt, very good, dirt. Mud is mud, exactly, mud. Okay, dirt is mud or dust, okay? They are synonyms, okay? Good. What is thoroughly?
Completamente.
Okay, completely, but we have one closest definition. Care.
The tile.
Sorry?
It's details. About details.
Details. It's about details. Detail. Okay, so totally is detail. Okay, good. What else? Carefully. Carefully. That's right. Very carefully. So thoroughly is very carefully. And I gave you some examples, right? Okay. I checked the document thoroughly. Okay, that means I checked the document thoroughly, revisé el documento minuciosamente, cuidadosamente, okay? So I checked the document thoroughly. Very good. What is sync? Sync. Sync.
Not?
No, but remember that in this case, sync is a, it's not a verb, it's a noun, okay? Sync. As a verb is hundir, okay, zambullir, okay, as a verb.
Fregadero, teacher.
Sorry?
Fregadero.
Fregadero, all right, or you can say lavamanos too, all right?
Lavamanos, so, fregadero.
The definition we have is a bowl, right? It's a bowl fixed on a wall, okay? It's a bowl fixed on a wall and you can wash your hands. And it's commonly in a bathroom or in a kitchen, okay? You find it in a bathroom or in a kitchen, so that is sink. Very good. And the last one is, sorry. And the last one is designated. What is designated? What is designated?
Designado.
Designado, okay. Or the verb is designate. El verbo es designate. And it's designar, like assign, delegate, all right? Yeah, so that is designate.
One people.
Sorry?
One person.
That's right, assign something to one person to do, okay? Very good, thank you very much. So we studied five words. Dispenser, dirt, thoroughly, sink, and designate or designated. We had the verb in past, okay? Very good. So taking these verbs in consideration, we are going to do one activity in a moment, okay? But in this moment, I want you to, let me show you here. Oh my goodness. Se me movió el doc. Give me a moment. Yes. All right. Anyways. Okay. So here we have the vocabulary. Now, here we have a checklist. What is checklist? What is checklist?
Checklist.
What is checklist in Spanish? Checklist.
Revisar la lista.
Sorry?
Chequear.
Chequear,
una lista de revisión.
Una lista de revisión. Another.
Una lista de verificación.
Another. Checklist.
Una revisión.
Una lista de pasos que hay que realizar.
Can you check a dictionary, please, and find the word checklist?
Una revisión.
And tell me what
lista
you find.
Lista de verificación.
Lista de verificación. Another one. Check the dictionary and tell me what that is. Checklist.
Checklist.
Checklist. Yeah, it's checklist. Did you find it? Lista de verificación, all right. Nómina de verificación, you found, right? And many people say lista de control, all right? So this is a checklist, okay? Lista de, even you can say lista de cotejo is kind of similar, okay? Very good. So listen, here we have a checklist, okay? Here we have a checklist. And we have some questions, okay? We have some questions. So first, let's check the vocabulary in the checklist, okay? So in the item number one, we have, this is, oh, first, right? First, this is a procedure, okay? This is a procedure for washing your hands. This is a procedure for washing your hands, okay? So basically, here we have some steps, okay, to wash your hands. We have washes hands using soap from soap dispenser. And we have the first word, soap dispenser, okay? So wash hands using soap from soap dispenser. Number two, uses brush, brush. What is brush?
Cepillo.
Cepillo.
Cepillo, cepillo, exactly, exactly. So uses brush to remove dirt. What is dirt?
Suciedad.
Suciedad, so uses brush to remove dirt from your fingernails, from under your fingernails, okay? Fingernails is like uñas, that's right. Number three, uses soap between fingers, okay, so between fingers, and on hands, thoroughly, like this. Thoroughly, between fingers, okay? Yes, thoroughly. Number four, wash his hands, look at this. Wash his hands. Okay, so the next one is wash his hands in sinks from production area. Sinks, look, watches or you wash your hands in sinks from production area, okay? And finally, dries. What is dries?
Secar.
Secar, okay, so dries. This is in third person, okay? Estos verbos están en tercera persona, por eso llevan ese todos, okay? So dries hands with a mechanical hot dryer, okay? And you see mechanical hot dryers in bathrooms, sometimes in malls, right? Yeah, very good. What is a mechanical hot dryer? Any idea?
Secador mecánico.
Yeah, it's like the one in the bathrooms, right? In malls, okay? So they are mechanical hot dryers. Very good. Now we have, so I repeat, this checklist is for hand washing procedures, okay? In a restaurant. Yeah, for hand washing procedures in a restaurant. So here we have two questions, okay? Question number one is, are procedure posters displayed or showed? Display is showed, right? It's the same, okay? Showed in some areas in your workplace. Displayed is showed, okay? Letter B, okay, look at the checklist. Here we have the checklist. Look at the checklist below. Design to verify the steps of a hand washing procedure. So this is a hand washing procedure. And we have two questions, okay? Do you think the checklist, this checklist, right? I'm talking about this checklist, okay? Do you think the checklist is effective to evaluate the procedure? It's to evaluate the procedure, okay? Es para evaluar el procedimiento. Is it effective for you? In your opinion, is this checklist effective and why? Why do you think it is effective or why do you think it's not effective, okay? So basically, we need to answer the two questions, yeah? Any question about this? So basically, we need to answer the two questions about the checklist, okay? Vamos a contestar las dos preguntas de la lista de verificación o la lista de cotejo. Any questions or it's clear? So question number one, it's personal, right? It's about your workplace. But question number two is about the checklist, okay? So any question? This is on page number 24, page number 24. So do you have any questions? No? Yes? Kind of? Not at all?
Not at all.
Not at all, all right, not at all.
¿Qué quiere decir? ¿Qué significa? Not at all?
Para nada, not at all.
Ah, not at all, okay.
Yeah. All not right, at all. Not at all.
For the moment.
Okay, for now, very good. Okay, so we are going to work in groups. I repeat, question number one, it's personal, but question number two is about the checklist. So let's go to working groups and please, question number one is personal and question number two, you can answer together, okay, in the group. You can answer question number two together in the group, okay? So okay. Is everything clear then? ¿Está todo claro? ¿Is everything clear then?
Yes.
Yes, more than clear. Okay,
let's go. Clear.
Okay, all right. Veo que bastante están con la cámara apagada todavía y ya son las 8:18. No sé si es que no están listos para trabajar ahorita porque vamos a hacer grupos de trabajo.
Teacher, yo cuando me paso a ver el libro se me apaga.
Ah, okay, I understand. En estos casos yo entiendo, no hay problema. There's no problem, okay? Good. Let's go then and answer the questions, please. Mm.
I learn what? Okay, este.
Hi, teacher.
¿Alguien va a compartirla?
Rafael tiene. ¿Cómo?
La cámara.
No quiere. No puede.
No quiere. Rafael, ¿dónde está Rafael?
Yes.
Puede compartir.
Tú puedes,
no,
tú
no
puedes.
Es, no es show.
¿Cómo ahí se está, dice tú puedes, gracias, teacher? Rafael.
You can.
Está, sí, sí.
I can. We can.
I can.
Okay.
You can. First is the personal.
Sorry?
First, question first is the personal.
Yes. Is yes.
Pero ponga las preguntas, question. I put the question. Please.
Gente venido Sandrita hoy. Okay. Estamos jugando.
Where are the questions?
¿Por qué no te da la 24? Page 24.
Okay, I'm out.
¿Andas perdido, Rafael? Ahí.
It here. Ahí me...
No, es esa.
Yeah, it's that one. Yeah, it's the checklist. It's okay. It's that one. It's number five. It's number five. It's okay.
Yeah.
Ahí está, ahí. Esas son.
Ah, okay.
Sí, exageran.
Esas son, Rafa. Thank you.
Más grandecita, no es que esté choca.
Quiero la primera pregunta. Que first is the personal, is the teacher.
For me, number one, two, three, for me.
Yes, there is, sería ahí, yes, there is. First.
Yes, there are, in question number one, because the question is in plural.
Yes,
that's right. If you have posters about procedures, okay, in your company, like around the company, you say, yes, there are.
There are. Second, look at the checklist. I'm up. This is the ID space.
Do you see only the manual?
Do you?
Ven solo el manual o ven.
Sí. Sí se ve, I see.
No se ve otra ventana, no.
No.
Okay.
No, pero no está centrada. No.
Pero.
Ah, sorry. Let me... Es que como trabaja en el Word, no, ahí sí lo ven centrado.
Ahí déjelo.
Ahí, bye.
It's okay. For me, question.
Okay, Azalia, are procedure posters displayed in some areas in your workplace?
Yes, there are.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
It's a silent vote, teacher. These are him.
Sorry, can you repeat that, please?
It's a silent vote. And I don't know if votes.
It's a silent, it's a silent group.
Yes. I'm waiting. Okay. Ada, you are ready? You are ready?
Yes.
Okay.
La letter B.
Okay. We'll start with the question. I start.
No la ve, no la he, todavía no la respondí. No la vamos a hacer juntos.
Okay.
Yeah, yes, number two is okay. Together. Number two is together, and number one is individual. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, number okay. Two is together.
Permítanme.
Okay, Ada, first, are procedure posters displaying in some areas in your workplace?
In my case, my company, there are no procedure posters.
Okay, excellent. You question at Joanna, please, Ada? The first?
Joanna, okay. Are procedure posters displayed in some areas in your workplace?
Yes, there are procedure posters displayed in my workplace.
Okay. And you, Miguel, are you procedure poster displayed in some areas in your workplace?
No, there aren't.
Okay.
Okay. In the second question, do you think the checklist is effective to evaluate the procedure? What do you think, Ada?
For me, it's correct.
Okay, and you, Joanna?
For me too.
Okay, it's correct. It's to me, it's equal. It's the same. It's correct. Why?
Why? Because the step the follow are correct.
Okay. What do you think, Joanna, in this case? Why?
Corrected because the steps are correct order.
Organized.
Organized.
Okay. The steps are organized.
The steps are organized.
Okay. In my case, because mention a series of elements to consider and tell you how to do things.
Mm-hmm. We are finished, teacher.
Okay.
Yes.
maybe what you, because I can see you have different answers for question number two, and that's okay, I mean, no problem. But maybe you can make one answer for everybody, okay? Maybe everybody can have like the same answer for question number two, okay? So maybe you can put the information together and have one answer only, okay? And write it.
Let me share your answers, please, and copy to the exam.
in the page.
In the
en español, pues.
Que me lo copien en el ¿cómo en se el llama? Chat. En el chat, se me olvidó la palabra. Sorry.
Ah, ok.
Share me your answer in the chat, please. No, only the last second one. Because we think is okay, but the why is different. Okay.
En mis medicinas tendría que lavarse las manos por la seguridad de todos.
No, pues claro. No.
Por, ¿cómo dirías? Por la seguridad de todos. Teacher, en English.
I have a question. Is correct say clean up kindly?
Sorry?
Clean up guidely? Guidely? Esperemos, no sé cómo se pronuncia. Como lineamientos.
Guideline. Yeah, it's okay. It's okay.
Guideline. Okay. Clean up guideline.
Yeah.
Okay.
But when you say clean up, I don't know, it sounds like clean up, but from my space, from a room.
Ajá, es que quería decir como lineamientos de limpieza. Mm-hmm. No sé mm-hmm. si está bien clean up guideline.
Yeah, but limpieza, but the problem is that if you say clean up, I feel it's too general. It refers to rooms, to bathrooms, to spaces, okay? And in this case, I guess you are talking about the hand washing, okay? Yeah?
Ajá.
So you better say hand washing guidelines because it's hand washing. If you are talking about the procedure we have here, okay? Or the checklist we have here.
Okay, entonces, is correct. Say these steps are effective because cover the hand washing guideline. That yeah. are currently important to the pandemic?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. It's okay.
Okay.
I mean, okay. clean up, it's okay, but the context here, okay, because we have what these items are for.
Clean up I use when I refer places.
Mm-hmm. It's more general, that's right. And in this case, we know that the different items we have are for hand washing, so you better say hand washing, okay? You better say hand washing because we know it's for hand washing, okay? It's more specific here. It's a specific checklist or procedure, okay?
Hand washing guidelines, okay.
Guidelines, yeah, hand washing guidelines.
Okay, chicos, I think the answer for the second question referent washes in different production area. Ajá. No sé, no debería ir antes.
Debería tal vez de ir al inicio.
Ajá.
Yes.
Lavamanos en el lavamanos del área de producción.
Ajá, bien. Cabal. Y después ya comenzar con utilizar el jabón, lavarse debajo de la.
Ajá.
Yes. Entre los dedos, las manos cuidadosamente. Y luego secar las manos.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Yes, okay, perfect. Just let me visit another group and then we go. Are you ready?
So-so.
So-so.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, let's go then. Let's go to the meeting.
Bueno, tomo bien literal nuestra palabra.
Sorry?
Tomo bien literal nuestra palabra.
A comenzar, Ion. Oh my God, you were about to start. I'm sorry, I closed sessions already.
Hacer un comercial.
Ah, I see. I'm sorry. And I... Oh my goodness. You should do it and I will see it.
¿Cómo diría? La pandemia no ha desaparecido.
The pandemic is still here. The pandemic is still here. Está todavía acá. It's still here.
Este es un mensaje del Ministerio de Salud.
Oh my goodness. I like that. So you present that to the class, please. Okay, okay, let's start. So listen, I am going to ask you the question, okay, in general, right? So I am going to select some participants to answer question number one, okay? Yeah? Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Yeah, okay.
Hi.
Hello, okay, listen.
No, hello, teacher. No, hello. My microphone?
Ah, was off. Okay, listen. Yes. I am going to select some people to answer question number one, okay? Uh-huh. And then one group representative is going to answer question number two, okay? One group representative. We have five groups. So I need one group representative to answer question number two. But that's in a moment, okay? So let's start with question number one. Okay, let's see. Adriana. Are procedure posters displayed in some areas in your workplace?
Yes. For example, and procedure is hand washing in the bathroom.
Okay, hand washing procedures. Okay. And what other procedures? Only that.
Only procedure.
Okay. The procedure that is very common in companies is the evacuation procedure, right? Evacuation. Okay, so that is in almost all the companies, all right? Or places. Okay, thank you very much, Adriana. Let's see, Ada Patricia. Okay, Ada Patricia, are procedure posters displayed in some areas in your company?
In my company, there are no procedure posters.
Oh, really? Is your company small or big?
Yes,
it's small. Ah, okay, that's the reason. Okay, thank you very much, Ada. Okay, Rafael. Okay, Rafael, are procedure posters displayed in some areas in your workplace? Microphone.
Sorry, no, there aren't.
Okay, very good. Are you sure?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Thank you very much, Rafa. Okay, let's listen to Zulma. Okay, Zulma, are procedure posters displayed in some areas in your workplace?
Yes, there is.
There are.
For example, how to evacuate in an emergency.
In an emergency, like a fire, okay, an earthquake. Yeah, okay. That's normal. Yes. That's very common in companies, okay? Thank you very much. Let's listen to the last participation with question number one, okay? Joanna. Okay, let's see, Joanna. Are procedure posters displayed in some areas in your workplace?
Yeah. There are procedure posters displayed in my workplace.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, thank you for your participation. Okay, now I need one group representative to answer question number two. Okay, so let's see, one group representative. quickly, rápido, quickly. One group representative, un representante de cada grupo. One group representative to answer question number two.
Margarita.
Okay, Margarita and Azalia. Okay, let's start with Margarita and Azalia. Okay, Margarita first. Margarita, do you think the checklist is effective to evaluate the procedure and why?
Yes, these steps are effective because cover the hand washing guidelines that are currently important to the pandemic.
Okay, nice. I like the answer. Very good. Thank you very much, Margarita and Margarita's group. Okay, because I know everybody formulated the answer. Okay, so thank you. Azalia, Melanie, same question.
What, teacher?
The same question. La misma pregunta, the same question. Okay, do you think the checklist is effective to evaluate the procedure and why? Question number two, letter B.
Yes.
Why?
If all four procedures are effective.
Okay, it's effective for this procedure. Okay, so do you have an explanation?
Yes, because? Because it is not number five, no teacher.
Number five?
No.
All right. Ah, number five is not okay for you. It's not effective. Yeah. Okay. Let me see number five.
Because it is not hygienic and damages hands when getting it.
Okay. Good. Do you think it's damaging because it's do you think it damages hands because it's too hot? Okay. All right, yes. Thank you. Okay, thank you very much. I didn't think about that, but yeah, it makes sense. Thank you, Azalia. Thank you very much. Okay. So only step number five or item number five is not okay according to Azalia's group. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, I need the other representatives. I need the other representatives for the groups. Necesito los otros representantes. I need the other
representatives. Teacher, Miguel.
Miguel and Ada, are you in a different or no, the same group?
No, Miguel. It's the same group.
Ah, it's the same. Okay, Miguel and the other two groups? Y los otros dos grupos and the other two groups? Ah, come on. Oh, all right. Lourdes and we're missing one group. Okay, let's listen to Miguel and Lourdes while the other group gets ready, okay? So Miguel first. Okay, Miguel, do you think the checklist is effective to evaluate the procedure and why?
Yes, it is, teacher. Because are mentioned a number of organized items to consider and tells you how to get the right by the following the rules.
Okay, so you agree with the order of the steps?
Yes, yes.
Of the items. Order. Okay, thank you very much. Yes. Okay, with the order. Okay, thank you, Miguel. Okay, now let's listen to Lourdes. Same question, Lourdes.
Okay. Yes, because these steps are correct to sanitizing our hands totally. The pandemic is still here.
It's still here. Yeah, the pandemic is still here. You say for sanitizing, okay? These steps are good for sanitizing, okay? For sanitizing, not to sanitizing our hands. Okay, thank you very much, Lourdes group. And Miguel's group, thank you very much for your participation. Which group is missing? ¿Cuál grupo falta? Which group is missing? No group is missing? No falta ninguno. No group is missing. Okay, Adriana's group. So who is going to answer? Who is the representative? Okay, let me select one. Okay. Adriana. Do you think the checklist is effective to evaluate the procedure?
Yes, teacher.
Why?
Sorry, teacher, for
No, it's okay.
Yes, because checklist is the help you know whether the procedure are begin complete.
Okay, yeah, that's right. Okay, that's right. Okay, thank you very much. Good. Okay, I like it. Okay, thank you for your effort. Okay, thank you very much. I know it's not easy, but you did it. Okay, so thank you for answering the two questions. Okay, thank you very much. Now, going to the checklist again. All right, going to the checklist again. I want you to pay attention to something important here. This is a checklist, all right? And in the checklist, you have different items. Item number one, item number two, or aspects, okay? Items or aspects, okay? Or criteria, criterios or criteria, okay? So you have, for example, item number one, item number two, criterion number three, aspect number four, and criterion number five, okay? Now listen carefully. Listen carefully. Something important here is that the verbs, see the verbs. The verbs are interperson, okay? The verbs, all the verbs are interperson. Todos los verbos están en tercera persona, en presente porque llevan S o S. It depends, right, on the verb. So this is important. Pay attention to this, okay? Now, and we have here, so the original verb here is dry, okay? For example, por ejemplo, el verbo original aquí de este, of this one, of number five, is dry, okay? So, but you convert it, and with S you say, dries, okay? Because it's interperson, porque está en tercera persona. It's like saying, he or she dries, he or she watches, he or she uses, and he or she watches, okay? Now, taking this in consideration, taking this as this checklist in consideration, you, in groups, you are going to make or create a checklist with five steps or with five criteria. I repeat, you are going to create a checklist with five aspects or five criteria, okay? Digo criteria.
Nosotros vamos a crear un grupo de...
A checklist. Una
lista de procedimientos.
Exactly. Una lista para evaluar un procedimiento.
Con cinco pasos.
Para evaluar un procedimiento with five criteria. Digo criteria porque... A checklist with five criteria, okay? Or with five aspects, okay? Now listen.
A checklist.
A checklist with five aspects, okay? With five aspects. Okay, now listen.
Pregunta, asking
cinco aspectos. Cinco aspectos. Cinco criterios. Yeah, uh-huh. Aspects or criteria. Okay. Now listen. The checklist is to evaluate a procedure in your company. I remember in...
Checklist?
Is to evaluate a procedure in your company. Okay? I don't know which procedure you will decide, okay? I don't know which procedure that you will decide that, okay? But I remember that in some classes before, you created some procedures, okay? Recuerdo que en algunas clases anteriores crearon algunos procedimientos. So you can think about that if you want, okay? If you want, it can be about the same procedures you created or about different procedures. You decide, okay? So I repeat. In groups, you are going to create a checklist with five aspects to evaluate a procedure in your company. Okay? Any question? I think it's very clear. Okay, it's fine. It's fine. No problem. Any question? No?
No.
Oh, okay. So we are going to recreate the groups. Vamos a recrear los equipos para que trabajen con alguien diferente. So we are going to recreate the groups. Okay, so I will give you, for this, I will give you like 15 minutes, all right? So please take time in consideration. 15 minutes. Que alguien 15. Lleve el, yes, 15. 15. Que alguien lleve el tiempo, por favor, en el equipo para que no nos perdemos mucho, okay? Select a timer. Seleccionen a alguien para que lleve el tiempo y les esté recordando. Select a timer, please. Por favor, háganos, seleccionen un timer. Any question? No? Clear. No. All right, let's go to work on the checklist. Everybody needs to have the checklist, all right? Todos deben tener la lista de verificación o de cotejo. Everybody needs to have it. Okay.
¿Cuánto tiempo es?
15 minutes.
Five.
De tu hi teacher.
Hello. Hi. Hello
teacher, solo queriendo confirmar, entonces vamos a crear una lista de procedimientos, pero no necesariamente de lavado de manos, sino que puede ser de cualquiera.
No, it's not a list of procedures, es una lista de verificación para un procedimiento. If you see the checklist, this checklist is to check or to verify the procedure for washing your hands, okay? It's not the procedure itself, okay? It's the procedure to check if people are washing their hands correctly, okay?
Por ejemplo, cuando alguien le toca hacer limpieza en los baños, va chequeando, ya hice esto.
Mm-hmm.
Checklists.
That's correct. ¿Verdad? That's a checklist. That's correct.
Okay.
Puede ser de lo que de cualquier cosa, no necesariamente de lavado de manos.
No. I mean, can be any procedure in your company. You decide. It's your decision. Okay.
Okay. Thank you. Vale. Entonces, ¿de qué lo hacemos?
Se me ocurre eso, Lourdes.
Uh-huh.
Por ejemplo, cuando alguien le toca la limpieza, primero hago baño, después limpio la cocina o baño 2. Entonces, ya limpié baño 2, ya limpié la cocina, ya limpié la oficina del jefe, por ejemplo. O sea, lista de verificación uh-huh. del personal de limpieza podría ser.
Uh-huh. Aunque sí, dice que es de procedimiento, podría ser como lista de verificación de limpieza, así en general.
En general también lo podemos dejar.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Entonces pongámosle checklist. Ay, perdón por el ruido.
No, hay pena.
Checklist. Y personal. Dry clean.
Deep.
Yo como es mi personal de limpieza, clean personal.
Espérenme, solo quiero ver cómo se dice en sí limpieza. Me aparece. No,
clean. You can only say cleaning checklist, ok? Cleaning checklist. La lista de verificación para la limpieza. Cleaning checklist. Yeah.
Ok, cleaning checklist.
Cleaning. Cleaning checklist. Ok.
Podemos poner como
sí, cleaning checklist, que nosotros bien largo hablamos y
pongamos a ver, como es una lista, no es necesario que vaya un orden, sino que vayan todas las cosas que la persona o las personas es, tienen que hacer.
Sí, los aires.
Ajá.
Tell me, Nelson, did you have any question?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, tell me.
My work, I doubt about the activity, for example, for me is it do evaluation five concept evaluation for a procedure. Is correct or no?
Yes. Remember, the idea is that you create a checklist to evaluate a procedure. Okay, any procedure in your workplace. Okay, a procedure in your workplace. For example, you can say what? Cleaning procedure, okay? Checklist for cleaning procedure, okay? Or cleaning checklist, I don't know, all right? Lista de verificación para limpieza.
For me is, I have in the procedure, in my work.
Okay.
The group is created, the procedure is a checklist, the evaluation.
If you have the procedure, that's right. Okay, now you need to create the checklist for the procedure.
Okay.
Okay, listen. The checklist is to evaluate the procedure. I mean, if, for example, this is for employees or for clients?
Pues employee.
Okay, so the checklist is to see if employees are following the procedure. Okay. La idea de una checklist es para ver si los empleados están siguiendo el procedimiento. Okay.
Sí, pero lo que yo, teacher, sorry, yeah. Lo que yo entendía de que teníamos que hacer una lista de conceptos o personales para ver si, para evaluar el procedimiento.
Exactly.
Okay.
Five criteria, okay? Cinco criterios, five criteria. Yes.
Five items. Okay, thank you, teacher.
Items, okay.
Item. Okay.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. Entonces, aquí, ese es higiénico.
Este es higiénico, sí. Es para seguridad en su lugar de trabajo. ¿Eh?
Ajá, sí.
¿Se logra ver bien o lo hago más grande?
Un poquito.
Es que no cabe, por eso que lo...
Ahí. Ahí está bien. Es okay.
Okay. Okay.
En este caso están los cinco pasos.
No. Okay. Nosotros.
Okay, listen. It's okay. Imagine you select the procedure, practice good hygiene. Okay. So you need to create one criterion for every step. Necesitan crear un criterio para cada paso. For example, number one is stop handshakes and use non-contact greeting methods. Ok, el criterio sería uses or doesn't, sería doesn't, no usa, ok, doesn't use handshakes, no usa o no hace saludos con la mano, doesn't use handshakes, for example, porque va en tercera persona. Ajá, y ahí le ponen un chequecito si no lo hace. Pero handshakes es como saludos con la mano, ¿ok? Handshakes, como darse la mano así, handshakes, ¿okay? ¿Ok? So that's the criterion, ese sería el criterio. Doesn't use handshakes.
Ok. Mm-hmm.
Teacher, second... pero estamos hablando con los procesos de lo del COVID o cualquier cosa puede ser.
No, I am talking about the procedure Nelson has. Practice good hygiene. Okay. You can talk about that or other procedure. It's your decision, okay?
No, it's okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you, number teacher. Two.
¿Qué haríamos sin usted, teacher?
Cinco minutos quedan. 10 minutes. It's fast. Clean hand.
Vaya, entonces este momento.
Clean hands at the door and schedule regular and watching.
It's basically, okay, listen, to make it simple. It's basically the same. Es prácticamente lo mismo que van a escribir. Solo yes. Que lo van a escribir en tercera persona. Okay, así de sencillo. Simple as that. So in number two would be cleans, because it's interperson, cleans. Cleans hands clean. At the door. Eso es todo, ese es el criterio. Se limpia las manos en la entrada.
In the case, ¿cómo es? Cambiarles, en este caso, lo que usted está diciendo. Stop, clean, todo eso.
Desinfecta.
Exactly, desinfect. Ajá, van a ponerle S o S al verbo. Ajá, desinfect. Ajá. Surfaces like doorknobs, tables.
Use this example. Mm-hmm. This is correct.
Yeah, it's correct. You can say practice good hygiene procedure. It's okay. Para que no se complique, okay. So you don't complicate yourselves. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Surface.
Number four.
No, como check, listen, the purchase process.
Procedures purchases. Okay, complete the product request form. These types a quote from suppliers. Pero es evaluar.
How many criteria do you have? How many criteria do you have in your checklist?
Five.
Ah, you finished?
Yeah, we are finished.
Can I listen to your criteria, please?
Yeah. El nombre es checklist de purchasing process.
Procedure, okay. Checklist for a purchasing procedure, okay.
Mm-hmm. Number one, complete the product request form.
Oh, okay, hold on. This is what I wanted to see. I said, right, that the criteria is interperson. So that means you need to put S or ES in the verb, okay?
Complete.
La S o la ES en el verbo, porque dijimos que los criterios iban en tercera persona, okay?
Sí,
así que aquí sería so, complete. So, completes, exactly, completes, completes, completes. Can you read it again, please, Joanna?
Complete the product request form.
Okay, read number two, please. Read number two.
No, vale. La leo yo entonces.
Persona,
pensé que seguía con ella.
Okay.
I'm sorry. Recites a quote.
Repeat it, please.
Recites a quote.
Receives.
Receives a quote.
Yeah, receives with S, right? Receives.
Yes. Receives.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, it's okay. It's okay. It's okay. I just. Mm-hmm. Okay, repeat number. Okay, do number three, please.
General, the purchase are ordered according to select supplier.
Repeat it.
Generar, ¿cómo es?
Generate.
Generate.
Uh-huh. So, but it's interperson, you say generates with S, all right? Generates, generates, all right?
Yeah. The purchase order according to select supplier.
According to the selected supplier. To the selected, selected or chosen, you can say selected or chosen supplier. Selected uh-huh. with ED, okay, with ED, selected. Selected supplier.
The selector supplier.
Yeah.
Generates.
Makes a certificates of receipts of products.
Yeah.
The last one,
pero es certificate.
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 Yeah.
Certificate.
I mean, wait, Susana, but the pronunciation is certificate, okay? But you write it certificate, okay? Certificate.
Sí, sí, sí. Mm-hmm. Makes a certificate of receipts of products.
Receipts of products, okay. But when you say of receipts of products, what do you want to say in Spanish?
Hacer una, acta de recepción de productos.
Mm-hmm.
Makes a certificate of receipts of product.
Receipt. The pronunciation is receipt.
Okay.
I have doubts about this phrase, but I'm not sure. I will check in a moment, okay? What do you want to say? Or let me check now. What do you want to say?
Hoja de... Hacer un acta de recepción de productos.
Okay, hold on a second.
Maybe that's...
Let me check. Mm-hmm. Repeat it, please. How do you say it?
May I check certificate in English or Spanish?
In English.
Make a certificate of receipt of product.
You better say product receipt certificate. Product receipt certificate. All right. Change the order. Product. Receipt certificate.
If you use das.
Sorry?
If you use, in lugar de makes, we use das.
I think it's in this case, I think it's make because it's something that you create, okay?
May a product
because it's like
certificate.
That's right. Product receipt certificate.
Okay.
You tell Margarita later, okay? All right, so you can practice now.
Sí, nos encontró sin practicar.
Okay, so you can practice now. It's okay. You have time to practice.
Okay. The end, no. ¿Cómo es último?
Sorry?
Check
reviews original invoice.
Produces.
Es como verificar.
Yeah, it's okay. But don't forget the S, que no se les olvide la S en el verbo. Produces original invoices, all right? Produces. La S. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay. Thanks, teacher.
All right. Take some time to practice.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello, teacher.
Yeah.
Almost ready.
Almost, almost. Only the last. Yes.
I recommend you don't use possessives here.
Ah, here.
Yeah, only takes temperature when entering the company. Takes temperature when entering the company. Sanitizes shoes with quaternary ammonium. All right. Oh my goodness. Keep social distance of at least 2 meters. Disinfects the work area, a desk or chair. Okay.
Thank you, teacher.
Okay. Maybe in this case, instead of saying like, you could say such as, tales como, such as, such as,
like, or chair. Like.
Yeah.
Such as.
Such as, such as, tales como, such as, disinfects the work area such as desk or chair. Yeah, better, much better. Okay, continue.
Okay, thank you.
Ah, no, es la misma. ¿Cuál era la quinta?
La de Michelle. Digo, de Adriana.
What is number five?
La de washing hands with soap and water.
El
lavado de manos. ¡Ah!
Se la envió. Do you send? Michelle.
Yes. Sabón, ver, enviar. Aquí la tengo en el mensaje.
No, ya la hallé.
Ah, ok.
Solo que para mí esa no es la quinta.
Ok. Reorganize.
I think it's number two. Number five is number two, I think. Because if you're not using alcohol gel, all right? So the obvious thing is to wash your hands after you take the temperature. For me, right? I don't know. Okay.
I think the same.
Practice the pronunciation when you finish, please, okay?
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Oh, nice. Very good. Practice the pronunciation, please, okay?
Yes, teacher.
Okay.
All right.
You start, Angela.
Okay. Protocol measurement by COVID. ¿Cómo diría 19? Teacher, no lo escucho.
Read my lips. Read my lips. How do you say 19 in English?
How do you say
19 in English?
COVID, yo solo COVID le voy a dar.
No. You say COVID-19. COVID-19, okay?
COVID-19. Yes. Okay. COVID-19.
Or you can say coronavirus in general. Coronavirus.
Coronavirus. Yeah. Okay. Protocol measurement by coronavirus.
By or for?
For.
Okay, for coronavirus, okay.
For coronavirus.
Can you read it again, please? Okay, that's the topic, right, for your checklist.
Protocol measurement for coronavirus.
Prevention, maybe. Prevention.
Prevención.
Yes, pongámosle prevention entonces, porque si es solo for coronavirus, es como para propagarlo, okay, too. I mean, that's what I understand, I mean, according to the sentence. Yeah, okay. You may say coronavirus prevention, okay? Porque imagino que para, imagino que es para prevención, right?
Yes.
I imagine it's for prevention. Yes. Jasmine, yes, Rafa. Yes. Okay.
Protocol measurement prevention for coronavirus.
Okay. Coronavirus prevention.
Coronavirus prevention.
Okay.
Coronavirus.
But I want to listen to your criteria first.
Okay. Number one is mandatory use of the mask.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, according to the example, you were supposed to use verbs, okay? Los, de acuerdo yes. al ejemplo, iban a usar los verbos en tercera persona, right? So maybe Cierto. You can say, because it's to see if people comply with the criteria, okay? It's to see if people comply with the criteria. So maybe in this case, for number one, you can say, uses the mask appropriately, for example, okay?
Uses the mask.
Uses the mask.
Okay.
Es que si digo it's mandatory to use the mask, it's like, es como que le estoy diciendo qué deben hacer. No estoy calificando si lo hacen. Estoy verificando si lo hacen. Y la idea es verificar si cumplen con algunos requisitos. Okay. Yeah. That's the idea.
Okay. Okay.
Read number two. Yeah, Rafa, go ahead.
Okay.
Just tell me, Rafa, you were going to say something. No.
Yes, and in this case, is you said of mask.
Exactly, uses of mask.
In the second, Rafa,
maybe uses the mask, because if you say uses of mask, estás diciendo usos, y sería usa, okay? So uses the mask, okay?
Uses the mask,
Exactly.
In the second, sería, habíamos puesto forward the sanitation, sería como...
What do you have in number two? Can you repeat?
Forward sanitation.
What do you want to say?
Sanitización de los zapatos, el calzado.
Maybe you can say sanitizes the shoes, all right?
Sanitizes
the shoes. Es como se sanitiza los zapatos. Mm-hmm. Sanitizes shoes. You better say shoes. Sanitizes shoes, okay? Y así, para los demás, traten de usar el verbo al principio, okay? Try to use a verb at the beginning, okay?
Teacher.
Yeah?
Teacher, entonces cuando decimos footwear, ¿cómo nos salía? O sea, como lo habíamos puesto, ¿qué quiere decir entonces? Footwear, sanitation.
Footwear. The thing is that footwear, it's a noun. No es un verbo, es un sustantivo. Footwear. Okay? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Entonces, en como tercer paso.
Or you can say sanitizes footwear. It's okay. You can say it. Okay. Sanitizes footwear. No necesariamente shoes, all right? Yeah. Okay. Sanitizes footwear. Sorry.
Mm-hmm. En el caso de, por ejemplo, toma de temperature measurement, sería take, ¿verdad?
Takes. The temperature.
Takes the temperature.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
All right. My pleasure.
Applies alcohol gel.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. It's correct. Alcohol gel. Applies alcohol gel. Applies. All right.
En plural. Oh, no. Ese es el, como es tercera persona que...
Applies. Se le quita la I y se le pone IS.
IS, okay.
Applies. Applies alcohol gel. Mm-hmm.
And in the last, we have keeps your distance.
That's okay. Keeps distance. You don't use possessives here, okay? Only keeps distance of 2 meters, you can say, okay? Keeps or keeps appropriate distance, I don't know, okay? Or keeps distance of 2 meters, okay? Keeps distance.
Yes. Es como un, ajá, un check, como toma distancia y si lo hace, check, si no.
Exactly. It's a checklist. Por eso es una checklist la que están haciendo. Ajá, it's a checklist. It's to measure a procedure or to see a procedure, okay? Es para revisar un procedimiento. En este caso, el procedimiento de bioseguridad, okay? The biosecurity protocol, I don't know what, okay? For the pandemic, okay? Yeah? Okay. So let me visit another group and then we go. So take some time to practice, please, okay?
Okay, teacher. All right. Thank you.
Okay.
Ay, ya voy a dejarlo afuera.
Are you ready?
Huh?
Are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Okay,
yes.
Let's go. Okay, let's go to the main station then. Let's go to the main station. Okay, let's wait for the other people because we have some people still working. Let's wait for them. And then we start with the presentation of your checklist. So start selecting a member for presenting the checklist piece, okay? One member of the group is going to present the checklist. So think about one member. Piensen en una persona para que presente. Think about one member to present.
All right.
Same procedure. Okay, same procedure. We need, okay, let's wait. Some people are coming. All right, same procedure. Okay, same procedure. We need one representative for each group to present the checklist. Okay, so we need one but other representatives, not the same people. All right, I need other representatives. Okay, so in this case, Adriana participated. Azalia participated too, I think. Miguel participated. So Miguel, you let somebody else do it. ¿Quién más Lourdes participated and Zulma, I think, right? Yes.
Yes.
Okay, so I need other yes. representatives for the groups. Okay, so I need other representatives for the group to present the checklist, okay?
Me, Nelson.
All right, so let's start with Nelson and let's listen.
Are you ready?
Yes, go ahead.
For example, my procedure is practice good hygiene. Okay, let me check. Okay, and the third, stop handshake and use not contact wearing mirror. In this case, in the evaluation, don't use a handshake.
Okay.
With the fear.
Doesn't.
Number two, doesn't use hands.
Handshake.
Number two, handshake. Yes, exactly. Number two, clean hands at the door and schedule regular and washing remain. Is the evaluation is eating clean of the door.
Okay.
And number clean three, clean in the door. Number three, disinfected surface like doorknob, table, and desk regular. In the item, disinfected surface.
Okay, disinfects. Don't forget the S. No. Disinfects.
Disinfect. Okay.
Surfaces.
Mm-hmm. And number four, avoid touch your face and cover your cough and sneeze. Is in the case avoid touching your face.
Okay. So hold on a second, Nelson. Sorry to interrupt you. In this case, maybe in checklists we don't use possessives. Okay, in checklists we don't use possessives. So you say, Nelson, avoid touching face. Okay, only
face.
That.
Okay. Einstein.
Touching face, okay?
Avoid touch face.
Touching face.
And number five, increase ventilation, be opening window or adjusting in conditioner. Increase ventilation is hitting.
Yeah, although in this case, maybe in the last one, you can say opens windows yes, and adjusts air conditioning, okay? It would be better. It would be okay. Better. Sería mejor, it would be better. Opens windows and adjusts air conditioning, okay? So the pronunciation okay. for the first word is practice good hygiene. Hygiene, the pronunciation of higiene, hygiene. For everybody, not only for Nelson, okay?
Hygiene. Good hygiene.
Hygiene, okay. Hygiene. Okay, thank you very much, Nelson. Thank you. Okay. Okay, everyone, go to reactions and let's give them a wow. Let's give them a wow, please. Go to reactions and let's give Nelson's group a wow. Okay, thank you, Nelson's group. Thank you for your checklist. And let's listen to another representative. Quickly, another representative.
Susana.
Okay, let's listen to Susana.
¿Tengo que presentarlo? Solo puedo decirlo.
Yes, you can say it. You can only say okay. It, no problem.
Purchasing process. Complete the request form. 2, precise a quote from suppliers. 3, generate purchase order to select supplier. 4, makes a product receipt certificate. 5, reviews original invoice.
Okay, what is the procedure for, the checklist for, can you repeat it?
Purchasing process.
Sorry?
Purchasing process.
Ah, for a purchasing, is a purchasing procedure, for a purchasing procedure. Okay, thank you very much. Okay. Thank you, Susana, thank you very much. So everybody go to reactions and let's give them a heart. Let's give them a heart. Thank you very much. Okay, next group, please.
Me.
Okay, let's listen to Ana Michelle.
Okay. I will present. Okay, checklist to prevent COVID-19. First, take temperatures when entering the company. Second, wash his hands with soap and water for 20 seconds. 3, sanitize his shoes with quaternary ammonium. 4, keep social distancing of at least 2 meters. And 5, disinfect the work area, such a desk or chairs.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, don't stop, please. Don't stop sharing, Ana Michelle. Pay attention okay. To number 5, okay? Disinfect the work area, such as desk or chair, such as, okay? What is such as?
Como.
Hey, como, tal es como, right? Tal es como, o tal como, all right? Such as. Okay, thank you very much, Michelle's group, for your presentation.
Thank you.
And now, please, everybody, go to reaction and let's give Michelle's group a like. Ah, Angela gave a heart. That's okay. Okay, now let's listen to the next representative. Who is the next representative? We have 5 groups working, okay? So I am missing 2 representatives. Who is the other? Who is the other representative?
Me, Rafael.
Okay, Rafael. Let's listen to Rafael then.
Me, not Rafael.
Okay, you can do half and half. Mitad y mitad, no hay problema. Half and half, no problem. Okay, Rafa does... The topic, criterion number 1 and 2, and you do 3, 4, and 5, okay? No problem.
Okay.
Léalo usted, Rafael. Léalo usted.
Okay. Policy is protocol to enter a company for COVID-19 prevention. Number 1, uses the mask. Number 2, sanitizes footwear. Number three, takes the temperature. Number four, applies alcohol gel. Number five, keeps distance.
Okay, thank you. Don't stop sharing, please, Rafa. Okay, thank you very much for your presentation. So this is for COVID-19 prevention, right? Footwear. What is footwear? Footwear. Sanitizes footwear. What is footwear, everybody?
Calzado.
Calzado, calzado, calzado. But where, ahí está mal escrito. Para la E antes de la A, ¿ok? Solo invertimos la A con la E, ¿ok? So you say footwear, ¿ok? Footwear. Ok, thank you very much, Rafa's group. Thank you for your presentation. So please, everyone, go to reaction and let's give them a wow, all right? Go to reactions and let's give them a wow. Oh my God, I see a few wows today. I see a few wows today. Veo bien poquito wows ahora. I see a few wows today. All right, so let's listen to the next group. Next and last group. Siguiente y último grupo. Next and last group.
We don't like, teacher.
Sorry? You don't like? No, I mean, your presentation. They didn't like.
They don't like.
Es que eran like, por eso es que no pusieron wow.
I think they like the presentation, but they are like, maybe, I don't know why they didn't give wows. I think they are having lunch, I mean dinner maybe, or they are doing something else, I don't know. All right. Okay, thank you. So we have a last presentation, right? Tenemos una última presentación. We have a last presentation. Yes, no?
Hoy estamos todos, tenemos una foto.
Pero hay varias camaritas apagadas. We have different cameras off. Y cuando les digo rápido, le encienden. All right. Cuando escuchan foto, rápido le encienden todo, miren. All right, so. Do we have a last presentation? ¿Tenemos una última presentación? Do we have a last presentation or that's it?
No, foto, ahorita no, teacher. Vamos a salir vispos del sueño.
Okay, so we don't have a last presentation then. No faltaba una presentación. Fui yo que me confundí. I am confused, maybe.
Yes, teacher.
You see, I'm not confused, right? I know we're missing one. So Darwin is presenting, I think, because Lourdes presented.
Lord, present, please. Okay.
Okay, go ahead, Darwin.
Okay.
It's your pick.
Be a safety protocol to enter the company's facility. Next slide. Number one, use a mask. Number two, disinfected shoes. Number three, take temperature. Number four, apply alcohol gel. Number five, show identification. That's it.
Don't stop sharing, please. Don't stop sharing. I said that you have to use third person verbs, okay? So you say, uses a mask, it's okay. But number two, you say disinfects the S, la S, because de acuerdo a la instrucción iba con S, right? Takes temperature is okay. Applies. Is that okay, everybody? Applies?
Yes.
I-S.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
I-S.
Yes. I-E-S.
Yes.
Yes, but no.
Okay, I was just quiet listening, okay? Solo estaba observando. I was just observing, okay? So remember, I will say this in Spanish. Recuerden la regla, cuando le poníamos S al verbo en tercera persona que terminaba en Y, precedido por una consonante, le quitábamos la Y y le ponemos IES. Lo mismo para convertirlo a pasado. si termina en Y precedido por una consonante, se le quita la Y y se le pone IES. So applies alcohol gel in this case. Okay?
ING
so
también.
Exactly. No, para ING no. Ahí no, ahí no. For that is different. No, 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 not for ING. Okay. Okay, thank you. Now, show is shows. Shows. Yeah, it's like, because you want to say...
Atendas, teacher.
Yeah, yeah, I'm going there. Ahorita voy. Es que no quería interrumpirlos. I didn't want to interrupt you, okay? I'm going there. Okay, thank you very much, Darwin. Okay, please, everyone, go to reactions and let's give Darwin's group a heart. Quiero ver cuántos están despiertos giving a heart.
Corazón.
Ya caché los que están dormidos ahorita, ya caché los que están dormidos.
Hoy no me dormí, echar otras veces sí, ¿no es cierto?
Okay, so let me pass here. Okay, go and have coffee, please. Okay, Ada.
Present.
Adriana.
Present.
Ana Michelle.
Present.
Ángela.
Present, teacher.
Si la cámara está apagada, no le voy a poner aquí la asistencia. Darwin.
Present,
okay,
teacher.
All right.
Teacher, ahora bien estricto.
Present. Es que no soy yo el estricto, es que sabemos, es que debemos estar conscientes porque se dice al principio, se da la indicación al principio. Yo sé que a veces es normal, ¿verdad? Porque están comiendo algo. Pero se da la indicación desde el principio en la presentación de que las cámaras deben estar encendidas y es requisito de INSAFOR que estén encendidas siempre, ¿ok? Así que para evitar que les esté diciendo, mejor si va a tener la cámara apagada, la voy a parar un momentito porque voy a hacer algo, ¿ok? O me quedo en el chat, me escriben ahí, ¿verdad? Y yo estoy consciente, así no les estoy diciendo. Pero sí es necesario que la tengamos encendida, ¿ok? Please. Y en, el caso de la asistencia, también en los requisitos decía, al principio cuando se les dieron las indicaciones, que cuando se pasa asistencia, se toma como asistencia si la cámara está encendida. ¿Ok? Ajá, ok. So that's why I'm saying it. Ok, let's see. Ok, Flor.
Se va a caer, Joana. Ah, no, Susan.
Present.
Ok, Gloria.
Me asustó.
Sorry, teacher.
Joana.
I'm here, teacher.
Okay, Lourdes.
I'm here, teacher.
Margarita.
I'm here.
Okay, Mayra. Okay. Miguel.
Present, teacher.
Nelson.
Present, teacher.
Ofelia.
Here, teacher.
Okay. Osmin.
Present, teacher.
Rafael.
Here.
Rosa.
Hello, teacher. Good evening. I'm on my way from home.
Okay. Sandra.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Jancy.
Present.
Zulma.
Here.
Azalia.
Present.
And Susana.
Present.
Okay. Te voy a pasar la asistencia bien cerquita aquí otra vez. Okay. So just before we... I'm sorry, Ingrid.
Teacher. Okay.
I'm sorry. My mistake. Okay, just before, well, let's go to the next activity. And in the next activity, we have some discussion questions. But before we go to the discussion questions, who has the one-on-one session today?
Me?
Okay, Sandra. Okay.
Me?
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, so let's go to the next activity. This is going to be one of the last activities, okay? So listen. Oh my goodness. Okay, so in unit number three, the name for unit number three is monitoring personnel. So the question is, in your company, who monitors personnel? Who monitors personnel in your company? Who?
Supervisor.
The supervisor, who else?
Yes.
Okay, your boss, who else? Your boss, supervisors, who else?
Auditory.
Auditory, personal. Okay. Yes. Uh-huh. Auditory personnel. Mm-hmm. Only
human
them.
Human
resources, HR, the manager, okay? So we have different people, right? Okay, quality, I don't know, something, okay? We have quality control sometimes to monitor. Okay, very good. Now, we have two questions, okay? So I'm asking this because the name of unit number two is monitoring personnel. Two questions. What is your daily schedule like at work? But for this, okay, I have these questions and I have like a way to answer them. Give me a second. Okay. Give me a second here. Give me a sec. Okay, let me share here. Okay, so listen. So basically here we have how to answer the questions we have here. So question number one is, what is your daily schedule? What is your daily schedule like at work? Okay, what is your daily schedule like at work? And you can say, for example, I start work at 7 a.m. and I leave at 5 p.m. I don't know. Okay, it's only one example, one idea, okay? So the question means, ¿cómo es tu horario diario en el trabajo? Okay, all right? Question number two, who is in charge of organizing staff schedules in your company? Who organizes the schedules for work in your company? I can say, for example, the manager is in charge, or human resources is in charge, or my boss is in charge, I don't know, okay? So please, take 3 minutes and answer the two questions. 3 minutes, no more. Porque ya les muestro ahí cómo contestarla, okay? You just need to complete the information.
Okay, just, teacher, thank
you. Yes. Write only the answers, okay? Write only the answers. If you ask me, for example, Bernardo, what is your daily schedule like at work? And I say, I start work at 7 a.m. and I leave at 12. Okay, in my case, right? So I work 5 hours only in the morning.
Teacher.
Yes?
¿Y cómo le podemos poner cuando son horarios rotativos?
Maybe you can say I have different shifts. You can say I have different shifts. Tengo diferentes turnos. Okay? I have different shifts.
Okay.
And then you can say sometimes I start work at 7 and I leave at 5. And other times I start work at 10 and I finish and I leave at, I don't know, at 9 p.m. I don't know. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
O sea, podemos poner como dos respuestas, se puede decir.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. But you have to introduce your answers. I have different shifts. Okay. Tengo diferentes turnos. Okay. I have different shifts.
Y puedo poner, por ejemplo, I am start work at 9 a.m. and leave at 6 p.m.
Yes.
In other days, otros horarios, ¿verdad?
Y otros días, other days, I start work at, and then you say the time, okay? The time okay. You start and the time you leave.
Okay,
thank if you. If you ask me, Bernardo, who is in charge of organizing staff schedules in your company? I say, my boss is in charge, for example. My boss is in charge, okay? You can say human resources is in charge. Thank you. All right, one more minute to finish. One more minute to finish.
Hey, teacher.
I guess some people have already finished, right? Creo que algunos ya terminaron. I think some people have finished. Use the same structure, okay? Okay, perfect. Use the same structure. I start work at and I live at blah, blah, blah. The manager is in charge. My boss is in charge. Human resources is in charge, okay? So use the same structure. Okay, so question number one is, what is your daily schedule like at work? Question number two, who is in charge of organizing staff schedules in your company, okay? So the questions are on page number 25, okay? Si no hicieron captura, las preguntas están en la página 25. The questions are on page number 25, okay? In case you didn't make a screenshot. Very good. Now, let's see. Miguel. Can you please tell me a blouse color? A blouse is like a type of
Shirt.
Women use. Yeah.
Okay, it's white.
White, Lourdes. White blouse. Y los que no tienen la cámara, los que tienen la cámara apagada ahorita, eso les vamos a preguntar primero, okay? Después de Lourdes. Okay, Lourdes. What is your daily schedule like at work?
I start work at 8 a.m. and I leave at 5:30 p.m.
Okay. Who is in charge of organizing staff schedules in your company?
In my company is the boss of each area.
Okay, so the boss in each area is in charge.
Yes.
Okay, thank you very much. Lourdes, now you ask Ingrid. Ask Ingrid the questions because Ingrid has a white blouse too.
Okay. Ingrid, what is your daily schedule like at work? Ingrid?
The microphone, Ingrid.
I'm sorry. Okay, I have rotative schedule. I start work at 9 a.m. and at I leave at 6 p.m. and other days and start work at 12 a.m. and I leave at 7 p.m.
Okay. Who is in charge of organizing staff schedules in your company?
It's my supervisor in some every weekend.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay. Okay. Very good. Now, let's see. Let me see. Ingrid, tell me a shirt color. A shirt color. Un color de camisa, a shirt color.
White. White.
White. No, no, another color. They said white. Another, a different color.
Purple.
Purple. Okay. Let me see. And I don't see purple shirts. Ah, Margarita has a white blouse, right? Ah, Margarita. And Margarita is very quiet. Okay, hold on, Margarita. We are going with you. Hold on a second. Another color, please. Not purple. Ingrid, another color.
Green?
Green. Nobody's wearing green. I don't see green shirts. Another color.
Yellow.
Purple? No, please. I mean, purple.
Black.
Thank you very much. Oh, my God. I was about to tell you, say black. Ya estaba a punto de decirle que dijera negro, say black, all right? So let's listen to Margarita and then we listen to Darwin and Adriana, okay? So Margarita.
Darwin.
Sorry, Ingrid.
Yeah, el mío es azul negro, Ticho.
No problem.
Okay, Ingrid, you ask Margarita the questions, okay? Ask the questions to Margarita, Ingrid, please.
Okay. What is your their schedule the like at work?
I start work at 7:30 a.m. and I leave at 4:30 p.m.
Okay. We single chairs organizing staff schedule and your company.
The human resources are in charge.
Okay, thank you very much. Now, Margarita, you ask Darwin.
Darwin.
Hello.
Hello. What is your daily schedule like at work?
I start work at 9 a.m. and I leave 5:30 p.m.
Who is in charge of organizing a staff schedule in your company?
Is the manager of the human resource department.
Okay, thank you very much, Margarita and Darwin. Now, Darwin, let me see, Michelle, what color is your shirt? Michelle, what?
It's sky blue.
Ah, it's sky blue. Miguel, I don't see your shirt. What color is it? I can see you're hiding something. Ah, okay. It's kind of, okay, no, it's not black. Nelson, what color is your shirt? it's white. Ah, okay. No, it's okay, no problem. Okay, so let's listen to, let's see, Zulma, what color is your shirt?
It's rayada.
it's right. Okay, Susana, what color is it? Black, thank you very much. Oh my goodness. Okay. It's a blouse, but it's a blouse, but we are going to consider it's a shirt. Okay. So please, Darwin, you ask Adriana and Adriana asks Susana and Susana asks Jancy. Okay.
Hey, Adriana, what is your daily schedule like at work?
I start work at 8 a.m. and I leave at 5 p.m.
Okay. Who is in charge of organizing a staff schedule in your company?
My boss is in charge in the area.
Okay, thank you. Now, Adriana, who? ¿A quién te dije? Who are you going to ask, Adriana?
No me acuerdo. I don't remember. ¿Es Sandra o Yancy?
I think you can ask Susan.
It's Susan. Yeah.
Susan.
Susan. Okay. Susan, what is your daily schedule like at work?
I start work at 8 a.m. and I leave at 6 a.m.
Okay. Who is in charge of organizing staff schedule in your company?
Department Human Resource is in charge.
Okay, that's excellent. Now, Susan, you ask Jancy, I think, right? Jancy is wearing. Yes, Jancy.
Yes, hi, Jancy.
Hello. I'm ready.
What is your daily schedule like at work?
I start work at 8 a.m. and I leave at 6 p.m.
Who is in charge of organizing staff schedule in your company?
My boss is in charge.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, thank you, Ada. Let me see your blouse. What color is your blouse, Ada?
Excuse me?
Yes, what color is your blouse?
Black and white.
Jeez, thank you very much. You are very sincere. Oh my goodness. Thank you very much. Bien sincera ella. She's very sincere. Okay, thank you, Ada. So, Jancy, can you please ask Ada?
Ada, what is your daily schedule like at work?
I start work at 8 a.m. and leave at 5 p.m.
Okay. Who is in charge of organizing a staff schedule in your company?
In my company, the human resource is in charge.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, thank you very much for your participations. Now, please, everyone, go to reactions and let's give participants a heart. Okay, let's give participants a heart. Thank you very much for your courage. Okay, thank you for your courage to participate. Okay? Gracias por ese coraje. Thank you for your courage. Sorry?
Ahorita que lo estoy escuchando a todos, soy la única que sale tarde por lo que veo.
Yes, that's what I see. But it's because you have different shifts, okay?
Sí.
Okay, let me pass the attendance and then we go, all right? Ada Patricia?
Present.
Adriana?
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. No se me vayan a salir, solo le voy a dar una indicación al final, okay? Ana Michelle?
Present.
Angela? Darwin?
Teacher, present, present, okay, present,
okay.
Aquí estoy.
Okay, Darwin, I'm here.
Present, teacher.
Flor?
Present, teacher.
Gloria? Gloria? Joana?
En realidad no sé cómo.
Joana? Lourdes?
I'm here, teacher.
Okay.
I'm here, teacher.
Margarita?
I'm here.
Mayra? Miguel?
Present, teacher.
Nelson?
Present, teacher.
Ophelia?
Here, teacher.
Okay, Osmin?
Present, teacher.
Okay, Rafael?
Present.
All right, Rosa?
Present, teacher.
Very good. Sandra?
Present, teacher.
Yancy?
Present.
Zulma?
Present.
Azalia?
Present. Good night, teacher.
Good night. Ingrid?
Present, teacher.
And Susana?
Present.
Okay, very good. Okay, everybody, just one thing, okay? This is the first day of week number 3, okay? Or section number 3. On Wednesday next week, we finish section number 3, okay? Miércoles de la otra semana terminamos sección 3. Unit number 3, okay? Prácticamente estamos ya en la cuarta semana ahorita. Son 5 semanas para este módulo. Así que siempre recalcar lo de la asistencia ahorita que están todos, okay? Sacábamos el cálculo de la inasistencia al principio y cuántos días dijimos que podían faltar máximo. ¿Recuerdan? Dijimos 4 días, ¿verdad?
¿Qué? 4 días.
A 4 días por si algún día entraba tarde o le agarraba, tenía algún percance y solo entraba una hora, dijimos que 4 días, ¿ok? En todo el, sacábamos el cálculo, me parece, ¿ok? Y dijimos que 4 días, ¿ok? Así que para que lo tomemos en cuenta, algunos han faltado, ya están al límite, Ya faltaron los 4 días. Algunos tienen 2, 3 días, así que para que lo tomemos en cuenta, porque aún faltan 2 semanas de clases, ¿ok? Así que lleven ahí ustedes el registro de cuántos días han faltado para que vayan viendo bien, ¿verdad? Para que no les vaya a afectar eso al final, ¿ok? ¿Ya? Yeah.
Okay. Teacher, solo para recordar que ya enviaron la solicitud de la documentación también para el siguiente módulo.
Ah, excelente. A mí no me habían dicho todavía, pero gracias por informar, Nelson. Así que estemos pendientes de eso siempre, de completar la documentación y de estar pendientes en recursos humanos también para que la envíen, ¿ok? So, muchas gracias, Nelson. Thank you very much.
No me lo han mandado, teacher.
Seguramente están ahorita. Seguramente están en el proceso ahorita, pero ya si ven que pasa mucho tiempo y no se las envían.
Lo van a dejar de oyente, Darwin.
Hacen la consulta, por favor, ¿ok?
Ok.
Hasta el 28 tienen.
Okay.
Ajá, cierto.
Okay, so everybody, thank you. Thank you very much for everything. Good night. Take care. Sweet dreams.
Good night. Thank you.
Good night.
Thank you.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night,
everybody. Good night, teacher.
Good night.
Angie.
Azalia.
Teacher, me toca la sesión ahora.
¿Era Sandra o era Flor? Déjenme revisar.
Sí.
Let me check.
Teacher, porque check. 21. No es que me he equivocado.
Vaya, 21 está. Y creo que a ninguna de las dos le tocaba a Rafael.
Rafael.
Que Rafa cambió. Rafa tomó mi sesión, por eso es que me dijo que ya me tocaba a mí ahora.
Ah, con Flor.
Ajá.
Ah, ok, sí, entonces sería Flor, Sandra. Y Sandra, usted que está para el día, déjeme ver. Sandra, déjeme ver acá. Sí, está para el 25. Tiene fecha 25. Okay. Sí, ahora es Flor, sí, cambió con Rafa entonces. Ajá. Okay.
Okay.
Good evening. Good evening.
Good evening.
I mean, good night. Sorry, good night. Not good evening. Okay, Flora. I'm sorry.
No problem, teacher.
Okay, adelante, Flora.
Solo quería preguntarle si me puede explicar un poquito más el uso de good, be better.
Yeah, por supuesto. Of course. Let me get a pen here. Okay, so let's see. Would be better. Okay, or let me go to the manual. I think it's better. It's better if we do it with the manual. Okay, let me look for the page. Would be better.
21.
Yeah. 22. All right. Yeah, 22. Okay. So basically, when we say would be better. Oh my God. Mm-hmm. Hold on a second. Cuando decimos would be better, when we say would be better, normally we use it with it, right? Mm-hmm. We use it with it normally. Normalmente lo usamos con el it, okay? And the idea of using would be better is to give a strong advice or suggestions, okay? Para dar consejos o sugerencias, pero con más intensidad, with more intensity, all right? So that's the idea here. Por eso dice strong advice, consejos que son como más intensos, okay, more intense, okay? So that's okay. The idea. And the structure is, I use the subject, in this case, it would be better, and the infinitive, okay? The subject, it would be better, and the infinitive. Que si usamos un verbo infinitivo, siempre lleva to let, mm-hmm. to go, to listen, to play, to study. Uh-huh. To have, to check. Okay, so that's an infinitive verb, okay? And the complement. Okay. Y luego un complemento que puede ir. And we have one example. Example number one is, it would be better to let employees decide. Sería mejor. It's like a suggestion, right? Es una sugerencia. Sería mm-hmm. mejor hacer qué? Dejar que los empleados decidan. It would be better to let employees decide. So it's a suggestion, okay? Let's check example number two. It, siempre el sujeto, would be better, y luego el infinitivo, okay? It would be better to let a manager take care of the situation, okay? Sería mejor dejar que el gerente tome cuidado de la situación. This is like an advice, okay? Kind of like an advice, okay? Yeah?
Okay.
So in conclusion, we use would be better for suggestions or advice, para sugerencias o consejos, okay? Now, but we have other uses. Tenemos otros usos también.
Teacher, el it es solo porque se refiere a los empleados.
No, no, no.
El o it, puede ser cualquier I, she, he, cualquiera.
No, no. En este caso sería el it, ¿ok? ¿Por qué siempre el it? Sí, el detalle es que necesitamos un sujeto, ¿ok? Según la regla necesitamos un sujeto y no podemos poner otro sujeto, sino que tiene que ser el it. A veces cuando traducimos, esto es lo que llamamos en español sujeto tácito, ¿ok? Porque no va, o sea, se usa en inglés, perdón, pero no se traduce en español. ¿Ok?
Ok, ok.
Pero sí debe ir un sujeto, que sería it en este caso. Ok, okay. Now we have other uses, ¿ok? Or we have other expressions to use this, or to give suggestions, ¿ok? Tenemos otras sugerencias, otras frases, perdón, para dar sugerencias, to give suggestions, o para proveer alternativas, to give alternatives, ¿ok? Podemos usar el would you prefer, ¿ok? Que sería aquí, después de esta frase siempre iría el infinitivo, ¿ok? Let me see again. Después de esta frase que tenemos acá, va el infinitivo, ¿ok? For example, okay, would you prefer, imagine I ask you, okay, Flor, would you prefer to drink coffee or tea? Would you prefer to drink, would you prefer, y después to drink, el infinitive, okay? Coffee okay. or tea, el complement, que es como para alternativas o preferencias, okay? Two alternatives, okay. Two alternatives, right? Would you prefer to drink coffee or tea? So coffee, one alternative, tea, another alternative, okay? Second example, wouldn't it be better? No sería mejor una sugerencia, okay? Wouldn't it be better, pero es una sugerencia en forma de pregunta, okay?
It's y like negativo, a, ¿verdad?
Exactamente.
Porque ahí va en negativo el would.
Exactly, exactamente. So I say, ¿no sería mejor hacer esto? Por ejemplo, en español yo digo, ¿verdad? Y no sería mejor limpiar la casa después, por ejemplo. Okay, so you say, wouldn't it be better, y luego el infinitive, wouldn't it be better to clean the house afterwards? ¿No sería mejor to clean the house afterwards? ¿Limpiar la casa después? So you say, wouldn't it be better? Okay, and finally, it would be good if, y finalmente tenemos, it would be good if. ¿Sería bueno? Sí. Y aquí yo les explicaba que cuando usamos esta estructura, it would be good if, el verbo que le sigue va en pasado siempre. Sería bueno si, ¿por qué va en pasado? Si lo pasamos a español, por ejemplo, en esta oración que está aquí, por ejemplo, okay, this sentence. Sería bueno si tuviéramos, okay, un profesional para completar el manual. Okay? Ah, okay, si tuviéramos. O sea, es como una suposición, ¿ok? Sí, tuviéramos, pero no lo tenemos, ¿verdad? Sí, tuviéramos.
Pero tuviéramos no es como futuro.
No necesariamente. Si tuviéramos, tendremos es futuro. Pero si tuviéramos es como una opción de una condición, siento yo, como una suposición. No es necesariamente un verbo en futuro.
Porque yo me imaginé el verbo en pasado, tuvimos.
No, no, tuviéramos. Ajá.
Ah, okay.
Aquí en este caso puede ser cualquier otro verbo. Podría decir, por ejemplo, ¿no sería mejor si fuéramos a trabajar hoy, por ejemplo? Si fuéramos, ese fuéramos, ¿ok? O si fuera, por ejemplo, ¿ok? So, si quiero decir, ¿no sería mejor si fuéramos a otro restaurante, por ejemplo? Sería mejor si fuéramos a otro restaurante, perdón. It would be good if we went, porque el pasado de go es went. If we went to another restaurant, okay? Sería bueno si fuéramos a otro restaurante. If we went, que es el pasado de go, okay? So the verb is in past, okay? El verbo que le sigue está en pasado, va en pasado, okay?
Teacher, okay. En este último ejemplo, will be good siempre va así tal cual.
Lo que esté en negrita va igual. It would be good
no,
if.
No lo podemos.
No, I can change that. That stays the same. Eso se queda lo mismo. That stays the same.
Ajá, porque vi los ejercicios en la plataforma de con esa estructura.
Yeah, it's the same. Okay. Ah, tal vez podría decir it would be better if. Sería mejor si. Ajá. Eso sí es posible. En vez de good, digo better. Eso sí es posible. Y lo he visto de esa forma, de hecho. It would be good. Okay. It would be better if. Yeah.
Okay. Okay, teacher. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much for connecting, Flor.
Bueno, teacher. Good night.
Okay, good night. Take care and see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.